Hi, folks. It's Chef Kevin. I just picked up this new tool from my favorite store, Sur La Table. And this is a truffle cutter. Let's take a closer look. So here it is, folks. This is the truffle cutter. It's made from stainless steel, so it won't rust. It's very easy to clean. It's very high quality. It's made in Italy. The name is stamped here. However, even though I'm half Italian, I can't even figure out how to pronounce that. Anyways, here's how it works. Has a knob that controls the thickness of the material. I really bought this for doing garlic, slicing garlic nice and thin, just like Polly does.
The prison dinner was always a big thing. We had a pasta course, and then we had a meat or a fish. Paulie did the prep work. He was doing a year for contempt, and he had this wonderful system for doing the garlic. He used a razor, and he used to slice it so thin that it used to liquefy in the pan with just a little oil. It's a very good system.
Well, it seems Paulie has a lot of time on his hands. Okay, here we go. That's very thin. I'm going to go even thinner, though. You can just about see through these slivers of garlic. They come out very consistent. And consistency is very important in cooking because you want all the pieces to be the same size so they all cook evenly. You don't want one piece that's raw and then one piece that's overcooked. So, nice and thin. And let me give you a little tip. Before you use that, I would rinse that under cold water in a colander. This will help take the bitterness from the garlic. So just rinse it for about 30 seconds. Now, they say that you can use this for chocolate, and it does work rather well for chocolate. If you want to use chocolate as a garnish, you just scrape it along the blade and you have some nice little chocolate garnish. You wouldn't want to use that for cooking, though. No sense in spending all that time making chocolate that's going to cook. So this would go on a baked good normally, or maybe in a coffee or a hot chocolate. Now, they also say you can use it on cheese. You can slice cheese with it, but I find that even though a hard cheese like Parmesan doesn't really work that well because it seems to get gummed up. So I would recommend this product, though. It's nice, it's sleek, and it makes a consistent product. Okay, folks, thanks for watching.